We use the term white balance when we are talking about color correction in digital photography. Most of the time, our smartphones and digital cameras are pretty good at creating images where the colors match our expectations. But there are times when the camera gets it wrong, or when we intentionally want to shift the color in our images around to create a different mood. Here's an early morning winter scene that I shot while out walking the dog. It was a cold blue morning, but the colors in this cell phone photo just don't feel right. Fortunately, in Snapseed version 2, we now have an easy way to improve images like this one. I'm going to bring up Snapseed's white balance correction tool from the main menu by tapping here. Now, I'm going to tap on the auto white balance button here on the toolbar, since my phone clearly didn't get the colors right in this image. That AW Auto here stands for Auto White Balance, and when I tap on it, Snapseed studies this image, and then it makes its best guess at how much blue or yellow, plus green or magenta colored light, it needs to add to fix this picture. If I tap on the Adjust menu icon at this point, then you can see what Snapseed really did here. When I tapped on that Auto White Balance button a second ago, Snapseed looked at this image, and it moved these two controls around for me. Like your camera in auto white balance mode, Snapseed's white balance algorithm detected that this scene needed a lot more yellow and a lot less magenta light to look natural. How do I know that? Well, because the temperature scale here goes from cool blue to warm yellow. Watch what happens as I drag the temperature control to the left. See how I'm adding blue light, which makes everything feel colder? Dragging the temperature slider to the right adds more yellow light, which makes things feel warmer. The tint control is similar, except that it controls the addition of green or magenta light. We won't feel this one as warm or cool, but its effects are just as obvious. Dragging the slider here all the way to the left adds way too much green, and dragging the slider all the way to the right, obviously, adds way too much magenta. Rather than resetting this slider, I'm just going to tap on that Auto AW button again and let Snapseed pick better values for both of these sliders for me. Now, I like what Snapseed's Auto White Balance algorithm did here. I like it much better than my original. But after looking at the before and the after a few times, I think that the algorithm went a little too far. I think that this scene needs a little of that blue mood to better express Montana's winter weather and the time of day. I think I'll drag the temperature slider down to about 20, and then I'll set the tint to about negative 15 to keep this scene a little cooler than the auto white balance tool thought it should be. Like all things auto and photography, auto white balance is a nice tool, but color is powerful stuff, and sometimes you'll get a more accurate or a more evocative image if you move these sliders around for yourself. Let me hit the check mark in the bottom right to commit these changes, and then I'll bring up another example for you. If I was happy with my work now, I could tap the Save button to save off a copy of my improved image, but in the interest of time, I'm going to skip over that step and bring up another example. While I'm opening up the next image, let me emphasize that color is a powerful thing. If the color in your image is off, even by just a little bit, it can dramatically change our feelings about your subject. There is no better example of the subtle but powerful role that color plays in our psychology to me than when we are photographing our food. When I was sitting in this restaurant, I thought that this pear salad was absolutely delicious, but my photo of this scrumptious meal, not so much. If you don't get the color just right in your image, then nobody will want to eat what you're showing them. That's one of the hardest things about food photography. Before I change anything here, let me point something out. This salad is on a white plate, and that white plate is sitting on a nice, clean, white tablecloth. Now, white is a vague term. Anyone who's been to a hardware store to buy white paint or to replace a light bulb lately will instantly understand what I mean. White is a vague category of color. Whites can be warm or cool. Whites can be beige or eggshell or creamy. I don't mean to say that this plate or that tablecloth are 100% perfect, but they are much closer to neutral white than they appear right now. In this case, the warm lights that were hanging above me in this nice restaurant are fooling my phone's camera. Instead of recording that tablecloth as a neutral white, my phone sensor recorded way too much yellow. I could tap on the auto button. I could tap on adjust and try and move the temperature or the tint sliders around myself until I get the mix of light just right. But it can be hard to know when things are right in this kind of scene, which is why the third option here, the color picker tool, is so helpful. When you first launch the color picker tool, nothing much happens except that a little loop, a circle, and a crosshair appear on your screen. What you want to do now is to press one finger against the screen and then drag that circle, the loop, until the crosshair in the middle is on top of something that's supposed to be a nice neutral white. I'll position my color picker tool over here, and then I'll tap on the before and after icon so you can see that it's already working. If I tap on the adjust menu now, you can see that once again, Snapseed is moving the temperature and the tint sliders around for me. It's moving those sliders so that the area that lies underneath the crosshair is as close to neutral white as the program can make it. Think of this like the auto white balance button, only this time we get to be much more precise because we are telling the program what part of the image it should analyze when it tries to remove the color cast. In this case, I think things look much more appetizing, so I'll tap on the commit icon to accept these changes. Let me press and hold my finger against the screen once more to show you the difference between food that looks way too yellow and pretty unappealing, and an image with the right white balance. Okay, one more advanced example for those who have made it this far. In this salad photo, I was guessing the plate or the tablecloth were supposed to be neutral white objects, but I don't know that either of these items actually is. They might have a warm or cool tone. They might be beige or eggshell. My point is that if the area that you choose to sample with the color picker tool is not perfectly neutral, then the results that you get might not be spot on. So, let me open up an example where I wanted spot on, perfect colors. Here, I have a pair of classic 1980s Ray-Ban sunglasses. I was messing around with these beauties one day in my little home studio, and I thought that it'd be fun to shoot some photos of them with my phone. Try as I might, though, I just couldn't seem to get the color perfect in the camera. I tried all the different white balance settings in my phone, but none of them felt quite right. Eventually, I locked the white balance control on my phone down. I set it to the daylight setting, since I was photographing by a window, and then I added that thing in the background. That thing on the right is an X-Rite white balance card. It's a fancy piece of plastic that studio photographers love. We love it because it is truly a neutral white. It's not beige or cool or off-white. When you buy a white balance card, you are paying for something that is precisely engineered to be truly neutral. I added that white balance card to my scene, and I was careful to position it so that it was in the same light as my subject. I had to make sure that my card was not in the shadows or reflecting some other light, but I didn't have to worry about it being in focus. In a shot like this, the card does not have to be in focus at all. It just has to be there. Anyway, I shot this photo so that when I bring out Snapseed's color picker, I can place the little crosshair over something that I know is a neutral white. Let me tap on the adjust controls so you can see what it did. See how Snapseed is compensating for the excess of cyan light that was coming through the windows by adding yellow and green? Mathematically, what you see now may be perfect, but I think I'm going to take things a little further and intentionally add just a tiny bit more yellow back into this scene to make things a little warmer. The white balance card plus the color sampler might give me accurate, but it feels a little uninviting, so I'm going to intentionally add just a little bit more warmth. Now, I'm going to commit my changes and return to the main menu. I could save my work right now, but the truth is, I really don't care about this test image. What I care about is the next photo where I took the test card away. Now, I need to stress that the only difference between this image and the last one is that I took the card away. The lights didn't change in my studio from one shot to another, nor did I change any of the camera settings. Total consistency from photo to photo is essential here. If I'd been thinking, I could have written down the temperature and the tint settings that we used on the last image, and then I could type them in here. I could have used the same numbers for the temperature and tint, since nothing has changed from that shot to this one. But I didn't bother to write them down. I didn't bother because Snapseed is remembering them for me. Watch this. If I tap on the new Undo and View Edits button, a menu will appear. In this menu, if I pick the second choice from the bottom, the one that says Apply Last Edit, then Snapseed will automatically add the white balance corrections that we set in the last image on this photo. Bam. That was easy. Let me prove it. To be clear, Snapseed would be copying more than just the white balance change from that test photo to this image if I had done other stuff. But since all that I changed on the last photo was the temperature and the tint, then that's all that's being changed here. And so with zero effort now, the colors in this photo are perfect, and I can hit the save button. Let me just repeat this trick real quick with another image from the same day under the same lights in the same studio. Since I was being careful not to change my lights or the camera settings, the same white balance correction, the one that we got from sampling the test card, works here too. Obviously, I changed the props from one shot to another, but since the shooting conditions remain the same, then the white balance correction will work fine here too with my ducks. I tap Apply Last Edit again and pow, perfect color in no time. See, for somebody who shoots products, or portraits in a controlled lighting environment, that white balance test card plus Snapseed's color sampler tool is worth its weight in gold. The moral that I hope you are learning here is that if you have images where the lighting and the camera settings are consistent, then you don't need to reinvent the wheel each time. Shoot a test image, fix its white balance using whatever tools it takes, and then apply those improvements to all of the images that really matter.